song and bush with Kalaba. Thank you, my beloved Father. It's officially recorded by Everlasting Gospel Center. Thank you, Father.
May the Lord do with certainty in your life and forever. Amen.
Hear the word of God. John 6, verse 37.
Above them, for him. O the Roger, when one Galatia, you were a secure kid. Find a secure kid. Grace, what is my fancy? But you tell him, you can put in a work and the first alien born spirit. Santa is pretty free freedom. Did I yet have a sinker? Yet, young Palladium, body of Sinko, a good new kid, a kid. In time before, in the name of Christ. Amen. How long are you on the phone for the voice
of the man? We are going to go to the room where Johnny was suggested. Papa said, I'll be a great dad.
I'll be a great dad. 37.
I'll be a great dad.
A great dad.
A great dad. Who more eternal than me? He is the me. You know what is eternal than me? Liban Kaya and Rock. I mean, Kaya want to.
Our first Bible lesson is recorded. The Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Galatians, chapter 6, verses 1 and 2. Brothers, if someone is caught in a sin, you who are spiritual should restore him gently. But watch yourself, or ye also may be tempted. Carry each other's burdens, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ. This is the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Our burden says is taken from the Gospel, according to St. John, chapter 6, verse 37. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. This is our place of prayer.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pray him, Jay. Zuleko Utu Abasi.
Brother, what do you refer to as the work of God?
Zuleko Utu Abasi.
What do you call theft money? The work of love is that which is referred to as above. The reason why you do not have the truth in your mouth or in your lips is because of your failure to do the work of God. If somebody decides to pay you a visit, and your own father returns such visit to the person, then the testimony arises from them. The testimony is there comes, the person paid me a visit and I return a visit. And that would only be the testimony. If you love somebody who loves you, then that is no testimony at all. If you pay a visit to somebody you know, then that is not a testimony. But eventually you pay a visit to a place you've never gone before and a strange land, then from there your testimony could emanate.
Brotherhood.
And again, if you being a brotherhood, only show love to brotherhood members, and all brotherhood members are them that you show your love to, then you wouldn't have any eloquent testimony to bear.
I think I've been a brotherhood. The one who has tried a brotherhood, you know, who brotherhood, you know, who brotherhood, you know, come on, Diana, conscience as ya.
But if by chance you being a brotherhood, you come across those who do not like brotherhood, they don't love brotherhood, they don't even want to relate with brotherhood, and immediately knowing that, you begin expressing love to such group of persons, visit them, try to draw them onto yourself, then you should understand that right at that time you have eloquent testimonies to bear in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
So on it was there. Ni yang dari ram sungkanya, hari kau kau ni yang ni yang kau mesti sekode itu mas.
Therefore, brethren, I shall not be tedious with you, but I want to use this night to show unto you or to tell you exactly what is known as the work of God.
Ilya man yang aku, kau rasa fikir kita.
It is not because you have money to give on to somebody, and because you have the money to give on to somebody who hasn't got. Then from there you claim that you are doing the work of God. It is not because you have something to give unto those people, or probably you are healthy and you allow the same good health to be extended to people, to another person, then you can claim that you have done the work of God, or because you are charitable. Show charity unto another person, then you claim that you are indeed doing the work of God. That is not.
Start by lesson.
Our first lesson will be
example. At Bobman Point to the Rotten Wendon Galatia, you were a city of it, fine course, a kid, course, where is my fine Siva? The Toyotel, a dear good world, can be great already. Before you even born spirit, it's a matter of free freedom. A die, a pure as in case, yeah, and permitted by the Finko. It will be okay, okay. In 10 for a enemy by Christ. Amen. How about you on Bob and Boston?
Our first Bible lesson once again is recorded. Let this flow for the apostle to the Galatians, chapter 6, verses 1 and 2. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such an one in the spirit of meekness, constrain thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. This is the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Sit down and do. I'm in class, I could go there in a year, in a year. Say Christ, I cannot be there.
Brethren, that which you have heard read out to you in the first lesson is the real work of our Lord Jesus Christ. The work which he has called on you so that ye may do. The services that you have to extend unto one another, which indeed is what he did and expects you to do the same work. That is contained in the first lesson.
These are the words of you, all of us. Through Christ, in a mutual blessing, blame your mama, Narati Ponomo, Tiongo, Mamma Westwater, no more move by the king, your old demoita. Come, Mamma, Amati po no kuku safu kemina no no. Yenu tu awasi. Kenyo awa mchios.
Amen. If you profess to be a man of God, a follower of Christ, I want you to do this. Do this simple exercise. This is the people who are less privileged, who are downtrodden, the people who have no persons, the people whom other people have rejected, the people whom they have so rejected, whom they will not like them to be closer to themselves. Good to them. Show good unto them. Be charitable unto them. Call them unto yourself. Draw near to them. And whatsoever you could do to salvage their problem and so fulfill the law of Christ. And for instance, a few of you, when sometimes you are expected to visit a certain community, and upon your getting there, you discover that the inhabitants of such community are not brotherhood members. You would not even allow the people whom you move together to visit such community or to have anything to do with the community. You call the person, please, let's go. There are no brotherhood members here. Please, move ahead and don't talk to them. Don't tarry here. Don't do one thing or the other for them. It's their interest. Brethren, that is exactly what you do, and it is not the duty for which you were called to do. It is not the work of Christ. You are not actually doing the work of brotherhood.
When you fellowship, I get on to mantra. When you go to crusade, I get on to mantra. From zero. Woman swallowed it for. Woman swallowed us. Woman, we could ready the door. We young, you meek, you come, go with me, and I'm in a camel by a wound, and I'm with you. Can't ever go in your son, I said. Yes, in a year. Yes, in my. For can I meet you from cook room for never a cook room for a man? Young folk also could be a cake cook in it, and
brethren, this is exactly how the Crusaders started their work. This is how Youth Fellowship started their work. That had been their point of commencement of the work of God in this kingdom. Initially, that's how they did their work, and they scored a goal. And that's why, brethren, the real work of Christ, the work of this kingdom, is when you draw nigh unto them who don't recognize brotherhood, who don't love you, who hate you and hate God. And these are them whom people look at as being evil. These are the set of people that you are expected to visit them, draw closer to them, visit them, visit their home, love them, and bless their home. And this, as you do, indeed, have fulfilled the law of Christ.
O kobi da ami ke brotherhood, ito ala sin, and you too in my samarina.
And the fame of brotherhood that you saw here spread abroad is about the children of God right now. This indeed the job that they are doing anywhere they go. Brethren, it is not forbidding to get married is the actual work of God. It's not sticking on to one wife is the work of God. It's not. When you are fasting incessantly, that is the work of God. It is not only when you are doing all these other things that constitute the work of God. The real work of God is when you love those who hate you in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Ekonmi, nwa yiyonko, nwa yiyonko, nwa yiyonko, ekinko. Owo imi nyana kima, nwa roe tawasiruwe, mbunenye, nwa wasi sokonye, manye.
In this kingdom, the war we wage is against the wiles and darts of the evil one. And therefore, the people whom they tell you get nearer being human, have to go closer to the person, do good unto them, pay respect unto the people, pay homage as much as you can, and visit this area when they tell you it's human, worship the person as though you're worshiping God, and this is indeed the fulfilling of the laws of Christ by loving this set of persons without this emanation in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Any government again is a good war against indiscipline. For brotherhood, war against sin. When one is young for women, you attack at least your own. You come go in a yellow picker, better. You can go to Lima, Lima, and to two, cuckoo, Nam to Queen, Boren, Castle.
Brethren, the work which our Lord Jesus Christ did and for which he used in overcoming the world, and such that he has commissioned all fully detailed us to get into the world to do, is to go out and love the people whom we people see as having hated you or disliked you. They don't love your God. They don't draw closer to you. Go there and love them as much as you could. Because if you look into the system of the world, you find out that the code or innuendo, common innuendo of the government, they say war against indiscipline. But in this kingdom, we say war against sin. And that is why as many as people look at us being evil or sinners, may we go out and express love unto them, show them and love them as much as we can, bring them closer to the system in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. There are many among you here who, if you have forsaken eating of fish and meat, you don't drink, you don't commit fornication, you don't do all those things you look at as being evil. And when you see other people, you see to be fornicators, they eat meat and fish, and they drink, they do all those other things. You separate your company from them. You look at them as being holy guys. You don't want to get associated with them. And you completely forsake them and forbid them and look at them as not being in existence. That indeed is not the work that you are called here to do.
How many ago them we told us? We told you woman, I didn't feel any ajarare. Women are at the late you. We were swallowing it.
Brethren, Brethren, the real children of this kingdom, the heirs of this kingdom, are them who move out on this divine expedition onto the areas that so are looked at as being no-go areas, that this set of people, that area is spoiled. You move in there, penetrate that area, and this group of person or any person at all who is looked at as being not good, you move closer to the person. Or the person who lacks good company, they tell you that person does not greet, that person hasn't got a good public relations, that person is bad. And people say, don't go closer to the person. That person is a fighter, is a cantankerous human being, a real good children of this kingdom. They go closer to the person. They move in there and ensure that some of that person they have known to have been overtaken by such fault. Then with the Spirit of God, they draw the person close unto themselves, bring the person back into the place of sonship, and bear the person's burden one unto another. But then there is a warning that you have to be very careful, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Because once you bear another man's burden, you so have fulfilled the law of Christ. Therefore, brethren, do not speak evil against the person. Do not mock, don't jeer. Don't forsake the person. Don't separate yourself from the person. Don't judge. Don't condemn. Don't scorn, laugh at scorn at anybody. Do not jeer. Don't say the person is not good, I will not go. But all you need to do is go in there, and as much as you could with the Spirit of the Father in you operating, repair the situation of that person. And ensure that you bring the person back. Be good to the person, be charitable to the person, be kind, be gentle, be meek, be mild with the person. Because that is indeed the work for which you have been called into this kingdom to perform it in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
This is why you
Amen. Brethren, 5 years ago, when the children of God started embarking on operation amalgamation of humanity, they visited the Biafran, and on getting there, they decided to go on this operation amalgamation. And on getting there, they were able to penetrate into the nooks and crannies of Biafran and unite the two peas, make coexistency to come to a conk, have become conk. The areas that people would not go in, they penetrated the area. They fetched water to many people, they split wood to many people whom a lot of others have forsaken and would not get into good company with them. They decided to wash their plates, they wash their clothing and clothes. They do all good things, humanitarian services unto them. And they wash their clothes and prepare their dishes, go to market and show charity unto them. And so, brethren, this was exactly what they did to be able to bring about the amalgamation. And at that time, you wouldn't say the glory of God was not revealed. That was when the power was indeed bestowed and the fame of the Holy Spirit was being spread. They did not discriminate to saying that because many people disliked some certain group. For that reason, they went far away from their company. No, but rather they penetrated there and did humanitarian, the real work of the Father. And so the recognition was done unto the Father, and the glory of the Father became spread all over the vicinity. And so the Father assumed his glory. That was what happened. Glory and honor be given to the Father in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
I thought him brother the Senior in Amelia. Could I buy a lesson?
Brethren, let our first lesson once again be re-examined to prove the real work of brotherhood which she has come to accomplish.
A powerful one. Otorokan Bon Galatia. It was a city okay. Fangi Kwasi okay. Kuros Wallace and Fangasiba. The third ten, the other could work a work and would wear a carry. Who formed a born spirit, a silent spirit, the free freedom. A die, a fair as an Kate, yeah. You, Baman, Bab, a little of Finko. If you do not get a care. In turn, we pray the name of Christ. Amen. About your thoughts and question on you.
The Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Galatians, chapter 6, verses 1 and 2. Brethren, if man be overtaken in a fault, he which are spiritual, restore such an one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted, bearing one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. This is the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay. Don't forget 1955 or 58. You got to under the move. You go then to my uncle. You go then to my mommy and your ma. Mommy and my cousins. You go and go then. You know. Bruce and Bruno. Mama, okay, 419. Now for the driver. Man, 2440. I'm being the pastor. How? I vote for. We talk about any money. Yeah, 2440. I know that you are. Nam no, I need you. So, I don't want to be the man who say, number one. You be Marian. Who will go again? No, my goodness. So, some jacket. Oh! You bought them, mommy. Oh, me, you don't get them, you don't get them, you know. I've a mother, you don't get them, you know. I mean, you don't get them. I wouldn't think of somebody. I'm not. A full floor, Tony, ma'am. Oh, I won't get them. I won't ask me. You'll get them, you mean they didn't. Say me, any two of us. For quite. And so, Uga, I can make come. And I'm more than me come. For quite, my mother. More than I'm going to eat them, one morning, I'm going to call us, make a brown. We know more elder. It is a way to go to your more. Well, your more Christmas. I didn't know I made a car, I didn't know my name is young for me, the sentiment. Second, now to Hanami Tote, young and short. No good me, darling. Mommy, not at the car, you something. You be number one. Then, car of cook at temple. Cook can't come up, cook while you cook, cook any covers, cook and paint. After the army. Nega namba dzufyo kaitaso avo swaswa kuti hokava se umuni ugere rekaswa zvomu aswara nami dio uyo hokava se uviya hondre
never recall initially far back as 1958 when I began my act of ordination in this kingdom I never ordained any person because he was righteous, or because he was rich, or because he was wealthy, or because he could express love or possess love, or because he was able to do one good thing or the other. My ordination was, that was not the criteria for ordination. But I decided to ordain those people who lack education into brotherhood is not for good. I know what is on your mind. I know that you are here only to brigand, but not to cause any good thing to happen. I will then grasp you and ordain you, give you a command. And for that reason, the people, they saw it to be an excitement. The people who were so ordained then, they saw it to be an excitement. Oh, no wonder. This man does not know what is my intention, that I have rather come to brigand this kingdom. He has looked at me to be good. Ask this Obu. Obu is a stupid man, no wonder he does not know anything. And you can see the way they were feeling. They didn't know that I know what I was doing. Because among them, once they were ordained, the next thing they did was to go out and inform other people that they had been ordained, they had been turbaned. And immediately you find them come back the next day with their companion. They go forth and look for the worst prostitute of a woman in the street and bring the person around and say, come, I have been ordained. You will be ordained. Ubu does not know anything. And I looked and saw your evil intention. I also grabbed that woman, though she was a prostitute, a fornicator, and a robber. I ordained the same person. Both of you become turbaned. And so, brethren, you see, that was it. And you find out that all those people, they themselves, they know what they came into brotherhood to do. That their coming into brotherhood was not for good intention. But to them, the ordination was that they were good. That Obu does not know who they are. But that was not the point. It was because I know that no man can use fire to quench fire. Rather, you can only use water to quench fire. And therefore, you find out that these are the group of persons whom today they see themselves to be so great. They are now assumed that pomposity so that they become their act of segregation. They are even operating in this line of segregation. They look at the other person to be evil. And they say, look, since you are not ordained, you are not to embark on any ministerial assignment. Don't go evangelizing here. You are only restricted to a certain area. Don't cross over to there. Have you seen the emptiness and wickedness or willfulness of man. Little do these people know that they are rather at variance with God, with the Father, by trying to create that dichotomy, that segregation, disunity. I wouldn't embrace other people, but looking at themselves to be more superior this time. But then God our Father, He knows the actual people, the real Aborigines, the illustrious children of this kingdom, they are not of ours. They are not ordained. They are there. They are not in the spirit. Because they are doing the work of their father coolly, in a very good manner. But for that they are not turbaned does not mean that they are not recognized. For all they know, man is in the spirit. I want you to know that this is not the duty for which you are called. For once you fight against somebody whom you think is evil, whom you think is not as turbaned as yourself or not good, this person is not good. Don't greet the person. Hate the person. Fight against him because the person hasn't got a good public relation. You are at variance with me. Your work here is to go all embracing and unite, try and amalgamate. There you fulfill the laws of Christ.
That's my first witness.
Brethren, my first witness is going to be brought about from 1 Peter chapter 2, reading from verse 18 to 21.
It's all right.
Amen.
Our first witness is the one from 1 Peter chapter 2, reading from verse 15 to 21. For so is the will of God that we dwell doing, he may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men, as free and not using your liberty for a cloak of maliciousness, but as a servant of God. Honor all men, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king. Servants, be subject to your masters with all fear, not only to the good and gentle, but also to the froward. For this is thankworthy, if a man for conscience toward God endure grief, suffering wrongfully. For what glory is it, if when ye be befuddled for your fault, ye shall take it patiently. But if when ye do well and suffer for it, ye take it patiently, this is acceptable with God. For even hereunto were ye called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that ye should follow his steps. Peace in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Friend,
And so, brethren, have you heard the content of the first witness? It clearly then tells you what the many people who have been ordained do. Because most of them, they use their being ordained or their position as ordained people to suppress others, to buffet others, and in this malicious act, they are at variance with God. And therefore, brethren, you should understand that your being ordained was not because you are righteous or you are a good person. It was because of your evil nature, your satanic nature. That was why you were ordained, you were Toban. So you may be transformed at the end of the day. And I can see that many people have yielded to this act of transformation, and they have been so changed from evil to good by now. But yet there are other people who are still stiff-necked doing evil, are using their turban to cause segregation, dichotomy, and to them is chiasm. You are not turban. Please don't come here. Don't come and sit at the ordained side. Don't follow us the ordained and go to anywhere because you are not turban. That is what they do. And they are still using that. Therefore, brethren, you should understand that your being turban was so that you was for a good intention, that you being evil at first, that at your later day you may be changed from evil to good. And I can see that corrective being meted on many, and they are following suit, being transformed the way God is doing unto them. For this is exactly the reason for which you were called in the kingdom and being ordained, so that you may be changed from evil to good. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Kuring bad day, kuring funde, kuring yene rempo, kuring namte si yinginde, oko bugin, awto bugini, buhore. O makan gue mi kiri yene de, kue di sanu gue, ini kemem, diyan kukulu, yane de, yin, ikonten sasya.
God does not extend his clarion call to us because we have fear for him, or because we reverence him, or because we are wealthy or rich, or because we do good things or good works. He does not call us because we love him, but he calls us because he has the good intention of calling us so that he may change us and make us abide in love, in oneness, in unison, so that we might continue in doing these good works. And as we are doing this, there will abound testimony unto his glory. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
So, as we are listening again.
Therefore, brethren, our second lesson we read.
John, you were a duty. Father God said, it will be a prayer. Book of Mark, eternal the me, yet in a me. You don't work at the me, living Kenyan work.
Amen. And our golden text comes from St. John Gospel, chapter 6, verse 37. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that giveth to me I will in no wise cast out. Peace, Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm a good judge. And I'm a father of Christ. I'm a good king. And I'm a good father of Christ. I'm a good millionaire. And I'm a father of Christ. I'm a good son. I'm a good teacher. And 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 then I'm the for them, and I'm for them, my convenience. King, the all will put the fee. I am going for that, and I'm going to get them for. And I'm going to get them for. But King, I would be there. If I get to come for, and I'm young for. Because I'm going to get down my pastor. I can't get down my pastors. I said, I'm going to make a brother, and you're scared of an animal food. You don't want to pay to him. You're ridiculous. I'm going to carry them for you. I'm going to make a ridiculous. So what did them for? I'm going to put them for the egg when I feed them for. I'm going to let China put them for. You would not put China feed. I'm going to tie them to a basso for the family. The grand piano, the vehicle would have made you win, made you know. I got back at a young brow, younger, we know, younger, so younger than the day, for Tony Pico. Or number two of us, two of us. Because you got a scarab. You didn't want to tell Jesus. Jesus, I'm having an issue. I said, book your book and tell you that me. I get to tell me. Okay, tell me the book and then you walk. You tell us anything, did I cook no room? No, my room. Come again. So I am a man. No room. Who's your room for room? You told the king and I see you. And you're going to go. He did well, I see. And he contains, I say, can you have a room, Jesus? Where is your number? Yeah. Yeah, yes, I know. Back in London, it's our way, then I'm mad at the young man, mad at me, so. Every time.
Sangat yang mukam-mukam, diangku yang mukam-mukam, ngomong hitam.
Ndongo kini kudepsha na mde mpolo. Nyoko, opo wale nyesi kusumitu. Kenyo wangu chiyo.
Brethren, the actual work of God in this kingdom, the work of Christ, is to coexist even with the people whom you may look at as being evil. Brethren, to be very candid, there is nothing like evil person, because that is not the way I look at them. Therefore, to my exemplary life, embracing all, living in peace with everybody, be kind to them, be meek to them, be mild to them, be gentle, call all of them together and live a mutual understanding life with them. Bring them together, give those who don't have food food, provide unto them who do not have. Don't see them to be evil. Don't see them to be satanic. Don't see them to be thieves. After all, you are now told that all that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out. That is the actual work for which you were called in here to do. Amalgamate as many, the entire creation of the Father, bring them unto yourself. Because for one, you should know that there is no judge who is friendly with our Lord Jesus Christ. No king or anybody who sees himself to be an emperor that is friendly with our Lord Jesus Christ. There is no millionaire that is close or friendly with our Lord Jesus Christ. There is no wise man or the wise men of this world or those people who think they are good that are friendly with our Lord Jesus Christ. But you see, the people who are so close to our Lord Jesus Christ, who are friendly to him, they are the sinners, the woeful sinners, the thieves, the robbers, the evil-minded ones. These are them that he called unto himself and transformed. He washed them clean, imbued them by their way, you know, by his word of mouth. That is why this group of persons, they are so happy. They look glad. And you see, for having been changed and allowed to be closer to him, they find it to be a thing of joy. And they cannot want themselves to be made separate from his company. But once you see anybody who claims to be good, professes to be a millionaire, or king or queen or emperor, these people are only in act of sacrilege, they are at variance with him. The reason is because they have seen themselves to have failed to have to their satisfaction, and they look at other people to be of no extent. And therefore, there's no reason to them to allow this lower class of people to be closer to them. That is not the work of Christ. And that is why, brethren, I still continue to speak to your share that the people who are ordained, the reason that you are ordained is for the grace of the Father, so that by that grace you be changed from evil to good. And therefore, do not say, because you are ordained, for that reason you don't allow other people who are not ordained to exist. Live and let live, coexist with the people who are not ordained, for they are all mine. And the downfall of as many ordained people or pastors or deacons is because of this pomposity, this arrogance. For they see themselves to be pastors, the other one is not a pastor, he cannot be nearer to you. He cannot, that equity to you, it should be inequity on it. But I want that closeness, that unity to continue for now. Because once you are made a deaconess is by the grace of the Father. And for being elected by his grace is so that through this you may be changed. Can you not realize what happened in the time of our Lord Jesus Christ? For one, today you look at other people to be thieves and robbers. For that reason, they should not come into the kingdom or nearer to you. It should not be so. Our Lord Jesus Christ knew that Judas Iscariot was a thief, but he elected him among his discipleship, and he did not cast him away. He did that so that he would be close, he would not have any reason for excusing himself. That's why he made himself close to him. Therefore, brethren, now that you have seen this, why don't you do the exemplary life? And in the first place, why should I cast the other people away? I make sure I draw them close to myself. That is why some people, even though they see themselves, they know that they are useful, they are sinners, they are thieves, they are robbers. But because I am close to them, or I make them close to me, they said, well, Obu is a stupid person, he does not know that I'm a thief. He does not even know us to be evil or satanic in their nature. And sometimes, even though I know you to be an armed robber, I draw you close to myself. And with that, I call you a wonderful person. Even though I know you have just finished committing atrocity, I call you a wonderful person. And by that, you will think I do not know that you are an atrocious person. It is not so. After all, who would have 100 sheep and one is lost? And will not forgo or just boycott the other 99 and go looking for the one which is lost? That is indeed the excitement in the God's kingdom. For you to go closer to the person who is woeful in nature, who is a sinner, who is evil, who is a thief, who is a robber, who is a fornicator, once you draw close to them or draw them nearer to yourself, you will use your own good spirit in transforming them and put them back into the place of sonship, to the place, good place of God, so that by so doing, you have saved them and you have accomplished a good work. Therefore, brethren, right from today, that is that sanction that is sent unto you as a warning. Because even right now, I have not boycotted that act of elevation. Those people who are here, even among you, I will still continue to promote you. Many among you are without promotion. I will continue. But while I'm promoting you, do not see yourself to be righteous. Do not see yourself to be good because that is why you are being promoted. But see yourself that you are only being promoted by the grace of the Father. I will continue even right now, right from now until the conclusion of this week, I'm going to give you that promotion that you have lacked. But then many of you, you won't even recall this gospel. You still be pompous and be so boastful. But I am telling you that allow this gospel to be your watchword, so that by that promotion, you will then be able to unite the flock of God, the sheep of God, amalgamate them, bring them close to yourself, be all embracing, be kind, be gentle unto other people who are less privileged. Because in so doing, you have fulfilled the laws of Christ. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
All you want to say in the Bible, Timothy, you will take, for I said you have to just make that today.
Brethren, the second witness is coming from 1 Timothy chapter 1, from verse 12 to the end.
Christ Jesus. Ikoro di apaniko, onye odoro wo bo ko ofre srete. Christ Jesus said that he kedere mbo di nyanga mi di owo. Emi amindi de itubo mo. Adi aka to amimbo kenta emi. Man Jesus Christ akpadami ntakani di owo ayara do free anyani mesie oyun onum ete unun nun te nda ke ibon mami edi tere de boli dem ye anye ogosun wem sisi ya mm ukpona yubon na edi de mami akara de ke bukre yo ami mi kana kandi pa enyen minyu ikana kandi kure nye pa ba ti kere ke ken sisi amen uyo mi ke nke men no fi timote yen mi nte akama yese nte nte kande yese ke ben diso nte mbanga fi manato ro afo anwana eti enwa yiran bori dem ye eti ese kama koro nusu owo ma to enye duo enyu ma guri ke uwe mbori dem Himenos ye Alexander edu ko tumbore oro mana ya mo esen setan kubo man ekpe mo ndi tre ido isun imo e ba kire mo
amen. The second witness, second from the first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Timothy, chapter 1, verse 12 to the end. And I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who had enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord was exceedingly abundant with faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. This is the faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. Howbeit, for this cause I obtain mercy, that it may first, that in me first Jesus Christ might show forth all longsuffering for a pattern to them which should hereafter believe on him to life everlasting. Now unto the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. This charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before on thee, that thou might by them mightest work and good welfare, holding faith and a good conscience. May learn not to blaspheme. Peace in the name of Jesus Christ.
Brethren, have you heard the reading of that Bible reference? And if you were told that our Lord Jesus Christ died for the sake of sinners, would he have believed? Would think that he came and died for the sake of the wealthy and the righteous and rich ones? But with that portion, you should know that he came for the sinners and died for the sake of the sinners. That peradventure by this death on the Calvary, the sinners will then be transformed, changed from evil to good. And now that you know, at this coming he has also come to assemble you, not because you are righteous. Therefore, having called you, you should desist from being pompous. Do not be arrogant. And then go about buffeting others, using silly and wrong insinuations or innuendos against people, beating them and recommending them for rustication. Rather, bring them close to yourself. Because if you beat them, if you look down on them, if you curse them, if you disunite them, you are rather abusing the privilege. And that would not augur. Therefore, brethren, I want you right now to try to use this same pattern of life to realize God's truthfulness and faithfulness that is true, and the love for every creature or man is equal, and then go about with this act of equity in bringing all mankind together with all humility in perfectness, for this is the work for which you were called.
Christ heaven, Christ student, and the Taras, the Bishop Bukumo, or the Kerimer, the Madam for Cowan, to come for Fonek and Muneke, come for Namu, but you are getting Adam for set example. I want to show the quick book, the classic Yemen in the Yaw, then you bung it in my room, go by a young from the wood. Who serve who can deck? Usuanabahu, any man of cook, sway them from Katai song. Then Bonga was a Yasaki, content Yasaki, be ten of them Jews.
And so, brethren, I want to use among you here to set an example of act of unequity love. Most people, or even the ordained ones here, they feel that for their being elected, ordained, was because of their good works, or because of their hierarchy in life, or being righteous. Among the ordained ones, and until you move into the pews of the Christ servants, the Christ students, the children of God, you don't look at yourself to have been righteous. That's why you were ordained or selected. But you should see that you were only being selected and ordained so as to use you to serve as an example, as a model unto others, so that with this good life, whereby you will exert from you, other people will live an exemplary. Therefore, brethren, having been chosen, you don't have to impute sin on people. Don't look disdainfully at others, that because they are not being selected or ordained, that they are not equal with you in acts of righteousness. No! But because you are only kept there as a model, so that with this good example, others will see and emulate. And therefore, right from now, you should not allow this good example to come out of you unto others. Shine forth as an example unto others for emulation, humble yourself to the core, so that by so doing, the work that the Father by his election will have been in a perfection, and others will live this exemplary, and this will serve to fulfill the work for which you are called for Christ's sake. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
To a day we are moving down, and I'm moving more. There will be again in work among my gun. Ready, man. You will make me the oil call. My brother, man, ready, man. It's a more than you can. You don't know, brother, when you are renting money from him. Mine, mamma, putting the oil call down a room with you. Can you read to my bassanada in Kiso? You get in Amtem. Cross of mass was in the toast walk and power token tower of a seminary. They didn't mean number and ten. We so poop. Yako Frecondo. And you could. And you know how you pointed to go Frecondo. Can you all know Jesus Christ?
Therefore, brethren, I want you to show forth good fruit and change. Turn a new leaf. Speak good and do good. And wear this exemplary life of Christ. Therefore, that is the instruction, the admonition that you are being served this night. And I want you to do this because this is exactly why you are called into the kingdom. Not false. Do not abuse, don't impute on people, don't condemn. Don't say the other person is evil. Love everybody, even to the people who are not baptized. The people who you feel have not done any good thing. Draw closer, love them, coexist with them. The people whom you fear do not love God or love brotherhood, go closer to them, love them. And be gentle to them, be kind to them. And through this exemplary life of our Lord Jesus Christ, I want you to really humble yourself. Because our Lord Jesus Christ humbled himself to the depth of the cross, unto the cross. For this reason, his name was gloriously elevated above every other name in heaven and on earth. And so, brethren, if we continue with this, from there, the elevation will continue, the promotion unto your life will continue. If you do this same work which he has come to lay as an example, leaving you as a model unto others, if you do that, then the promotion will continue in your life and you will have a cause to testify eloquently unto our Father's glory in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to Jesus in the to get James Luniba. Don't I cut by first to just with it.
A third witness comes from the book of James, chapter 2, beginning from verse 2 to 13.
From verse 1 to 12.
Thank you, Father. Beginning from verse 1, week to 12.
Yon tin sin ni ta toke we dems vere siye iba tonga ke pofa osum duwe ba ito teni ikudan bori jani mbukwe yine de yobon nyin Jesus Christ ebi yine de ubon idian yu tenengen kuri di ku wemi sinere mpanyo no gul yedi yo from the model de di case mbufu iye no we na mi esne de yedi de yo from o yo modo de di ndien mbufu e se de risne yedi yo from idem edo anye de titi mi kitie kititie iye wa do iye no we de daru ni de sore mi gison kembe no do kudme Dembofrienekis River. Even without Quanaki Caribbean, Point Owo, a group demanded to attend me. Tavasi, Ikemeke,
Timaka,
Ikemeke, Mommy, Ebonekem, Poiling Woods, Emmy, a Temmo, a Furo can body them. Even when you know you bomb, Emmy and Yanko Mongade, they not mommy a madding. Edimbofo, a mice when a yellow bunny. Tell them, Mayenne, Kiene Tombofo. Temmo, Kidemmo. It will came before, Ikaki, it's here very fair. Temmo is only getting him. Every good day, Buffetian. Eddie, they came before, and they worried them. They were taken wherever I sit there. My boy don't fund there. Maddy them before, and I'm so fond there. Eddie, they came before, it turned away before, and I'm a young boy. If you don't know what you want Ete, maybe I regret. Could we carry a kidnum there or free bed? It is where they can take it, but I covered it with so cool free bed. Could a yen your own ete, cousin of her? Or on great a cool roo. It is a Muslim care for it. It would do my cavalry of your bed. A tempo, you an ampo, and ten money of a city that is bed, a can am the war often, a quick one more. Guru, you put me in a can bomb, you woke me to our womb bomb, it in bomb of room broke and it's fair. Did I tell me?
Oh, good.
I meant get home on Jesus.
For the rape and witness, it's from the Epistle General of James, chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. My brethren, have not the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, with respect of persons. For if there come unto your assembly a man with a golden ring in goodly apparel, and there come in also a poor man in vile raiment, the guy gloating and say unto him, sit thou here in a good place, and say to the poor, stand thou there, or sit here under my footstool. Are ye not the partial in yourself, and are become judges of evil thoughts? Hearken, my beloved brethren, had not God chosen the poor of this world, rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom which he had promised to them that love him? But ye have despised the poor. Do not rich men oppress you and draw you before the judgment seat? Do not they blaspheme that worthy name by the which ye are called? If ye fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself, ye do well. But if ye have respect to the persons, ye commit sin, and are convinced of the law as transgressors. For whosoever shall keep the whole law, and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all. For he that saith, do not commit adultery, saith also, do not kill. Now, if thou commit no adultery, yet if thou kill, thou art become a transgressor of the law. So speak ye, and do so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of the liberty. Peace in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Have you heard the reading of the first witness? That is that Brethren, I do not intend to take you too far, further than this. It is said a stroke of a cane is enough to teach a wise man. Let he who has ear hear. May God bless his holy word.